locks are off.
I'm George Murphy from Abbeville, Alabama. In August of 1954, when then is known as the old farm all tractor business. It's a general farming area, which is now basically peanuts and a little bit of cotton. Our biggest seller was the Super C tractor. Sold one or two of Super M's. They started numbering, sold several 300, I believe, utility 300. And they all at that time, even the Super C and all of them, had what the company called Fast Hitch, which in our neck of the woods, people were used to three-point ball hitch like Ford and Ferguson. John Deere went to that, and when he did, there were very few farm all tractors sold because of sticking with the fast hitch rather than joining the crowd. They should have gone like the rest of the tractor companies were doing with a three-point hitch. A few of the Super C's, Super M, 300, let's see, what was the other number? After 60 something years, I guess I've forgotten what the other number was. We went in from 54 to 59. The tractor market had been pretty well saturated. Right after World War II, when the farmers had the old farm all dealer, Robert's Trucking Tractor, and he had filled the country full of C's and Super C's and H's from 46 up until 54. Not knowing what day it was getting into, didn't realize that the market had been pretty well satisfied. They didn't trade like they do now every year. Got a new tractor, had to wear them out. An old farm all would last a long time. In the fall of the year, one of the main things of business, what they used to call the 3-to-5 model, was on stationary hay bale. And mechanically, I had a reputation that nobody else could fix a 3-to-5. He could, because they would have them coming in from the three surrounding counties and bring his little 3-to-5 motor in for him to get it to run. And he could fix one in short order. But the Super C, well, I believe they changed it. The Super C was changed to the 200 series, is what it was called. Had a chrome letter out of 200. 300 utility, we sold a few of them. A few pickups. The first ones we sold with the R-Line with the two glasses in the back window, which they later changed to one solid glass all the way across. And then after the L line, R line, well, it started off the two windows and that window in the R's, L series, R line, and then they went to the one big glass, and that even held on the 190 trucks, which we sold several of them. We had a company that we were doing business with. We sold five of the 190s at one time. And that was, I'd say that was the height of the 5 years we was in the business. But the 190s series on trucks was a good seller. The appliances that International was putting out, the freezers, refrigerators, and air conditioners, we have a, some, after the tractor business, it was in the feed and seed business. And so the refrigerator that we left and we sold out in 2002. They're still running, 8.5. So refrigerator size, same compressor, same compressor. Of course, we've had to replace the gasket on the door. But if International Harvester hadn't been so stuck up, the Chicago engineers, everything needed to go fast hit. That put them out of the business in our part of the country. Because everybody wanted a three-point hitch, because they already had a lot of three-point equipment. And they didn't adapt. Well, they had adapters, but they didn't want to be bothered with that. They put the adapter on where they could use some equipment they already had. And the zone man was strictly gung-ho International Harvester. Who just recently died. Herb Metcalf, he was International up and down. Fella Johnson was a trucker. That was, back then, each state had their own distribution for International Harvester. We drew out of Birmingham, which was 200 miles up the road. But, it's such a difference, it's so much more. Technical, computer welcome stuff. And the tractors that we sold were for two-row equipment. And by the time we got out, a few of them beginning to go four-row. Our land is rolling. And they had to do some adapting to keep from washing contour farming. We had the terraces run with the slope of the hill. Now with these 6-row and 8-row, that field of yours is washing away.
I saw that.
Man, I did.
Didn't y'all go up to the Chicago plant to get some, pick up some trucks up there and drive them back?
No, Springfield.
Springfield.
Springfield and Fort Wayne driveway. And in the 5 years that we was in it, 50 to 75 radius from Abbeville. Five other international dealers went out of business. They just couldn't sell. But we did stay, well, I got out after 5 years. My brother kept it another year and then left. He had to throw in the towel. And it was, and at that time, let's see, I'd been out of the Army 2 years. I got out of the Army in 52. And, you know, no experience in our business type of thing. We had an old mechanic. Nothing diplomatic about it. He was very abrupt. But everybody believed in him to work on that track. Like the old H&M's, Cubs, and the B, C. They could go through one of them in short time, but they still went back to the fact that they didn't have a three-point hitch equipment. So that was the other five dealers that went out in a period of time. We win. It's no doubt about it. They built good equipment. They pickup trucks, rough ride. And you couldn't wear them out. The old KB line truck, KB 6 and 7. Man, it was a lot of those trucks that the previous owner had sold. They were still running 15, 20 years. But the KB line 6 and 7 was the workhorse of the truck back then. You got on anything, you got to have enough volume to start realizing you got so much open door expense to start with, whether you sell a piece of equipment or not. But I guess we did sell in proportion we sold more of the appliances than we did tractors and trucks.
Y'all sell very many combines?
We might have sold one or two.
And it was
another fiasco, the automatic hay balers was not built for peanut hay. There was so much dirt in the hay until it kept the nozzles. We, the servicemen, stayed down from Birmingham. The two automatic hay balers that we sold, trying, we had both of them in, and you couldn't give them another. Because that dirt would grind out the nozzles and get out of time. I don't know, but gained some good experience, but I sure wouldn't want to go back through it again. You get tired eating a hot dog for breakfast, that's all. So you had to pay your help. We came up on the short end. That's basically, I might think of something else later on, right now, unless you got some question.
Okay.